254 News highlights. We move straight to our discussion tonight, where we are talking about the county governance and fund usage, where we saw Derito Moreithio sacking 176 workers in his county government. And I'm speaking to my guest here. She's a lawyer, Jerusa Michael, and Thomas Omao, political scientist. Want to know whether the move was okay and should other county governments adopt the same thing, and indeed if the whole country would adopt that system of reducing the numbers of workers. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
Yes,
good to have you.
Mm-hmm.
Now I want to get your views. How do you feel the message? How do you appreciate, or how do you feel the move by Governor Derito to sack 176 workers in his county government? I'll begin with you, Jerusa.
Okay, so first of all, I think the issue of redundancy in Kenya is something that we've really experienced, especially in the past year and this year. Mm-hmm. We've seen several institutions sacking their employees on account of redundancy. We've seen Stanbic, we've seen Telkom Kenya, we've seen Portland Cement. And so when in 2020 we wake up again and it's government institutions now, it's the county that is sacking employees on account of redundancy, then I think it's a little bit shocking, first of all, considering it's the it's county government, it's a government institution. And in as much as the law provides that the wage bill should be capped at 35%, it's not just the county government of Laikipia. I think there are so many, most of the counties and the national government at large, the wage bill is high. We all know the wage bill is high. Mm-hmm. But who was sacked? The messengers, you know, mm-hmm. at least it's the messengers, you know, switchboard operators, and those low income earning people. Mm-hmm. Are those people the ones who are raising this wage bill? Is it going to have a very different impact? Who are getting the huge salaries? Mm-hmm. Who is pocketing that money that is coming up to 58%, or I think it's 58% of mm-hmm. the wage bill? I think those are the issues that we need to consider, because we know in Kenya, we have this, actually, I think statistics show that we have like 80% of Kenyans earning, you know, very mm-hmm. little money, and then we have millions and billions of money with a little 10% or 20%. I think it's even 10%.
All right.
So I think in as much as it's supposed to be compliant with the law, as the governor and the county government puts it, mm-hmm. there is so much that needs to go into that.
Mm-hmm. Now, Thomas, we saw a similar thing being done by Nairobi Governor Sonko, and now it is in Laikipia. And many people will say, like she has mentioned, these are the people we would want to know, who are these people that were sacked? Are they the lowly paid, and are they the majority? And if they are, was the move okay? How do you feel about that?
Okay, thanks, Hillary. Foremost, I'll say that I respect the opinion of my sister Jerusha on the same of what she has actually said. But Hillary, I can actually attest that I was going through the county public service audit report by the Laikipia county, the chairperson of the county public service board. That is Madam Mumbi Mwago. With respect to this report, she said that we have people in the county, in Laikipia county, who actually had no proper academic papers. They had no proper academic qualifications to hold various positions. Mm-hmm. And as such, with respect to her, she said that these people should be laid off. Number two, we find that Laikipia County spends up to 180.8 million mm-hmm. Per month. That is just on recurrent expenditure. That is on salaries and such stuff. You find that that's a lot of money, my friend. Comparing, what does the law say? For instance, look at the Public Finance Management of Act of 2012. It says that the wage bill should not go beyond 35%. Mm-hmm. That is in terms of maybe salaries and such. But we find that in Laikipia County, it was up to 58%, which mm-hmm. is not good. In fact, the governor should actually explain. You should explain that even in court. It's not good to hire a lot of people, maybe due to political patronage or due to such. So in my opinion, I think other governors should follow suit, let them follow the law, and those people who will be employed should be actually be employed. Instead of employing a lot of people who do nothing and with no meaningful employment in the county. That is my opinion, Hillary.
All right. Now, Jerusalem, with Laikipia County, given an example, spending 190.8 million shillings on wage bill, I'm sure other larger counties in this country spends a whole lot. But also, we're talking about the county funds allocation. They're claiming they need more money to the Mashinani. That has been their call. Actually, even the as we speak, COG were meeting because they haven't been reimbursed the money they want. The money has not been dispersed to the counties. But also looking into matters of employment. Those were people who were taking unga back home every day, but now they will not. We're also looking at how funds is, how money is being used in the counties. Now, do you think it is the wage bill that was being misappropriated other than the projects that have been done in the counties?
Okay, first of all, let me respond to my friend here, Thomas. Yes. My issue is not that it's not the right thing to, you know, we know the law provides for 35%, it is clear. In fact, and I think one thing that I've seen from the process, they have tried to follow the law, because the law that governs laying off employees on account of redundancy. First of all, you need to look at Section 40 of the Employment Act, whereby you notify, at least if there's a trade union, they are notified at least 1 month before, or if the person is not a member of a trade union, then they should be notified at least 1 month before, or given one month's salary in lieu of notice, and also severance pay. Severance pay at least 15 days a year for all the years served. And from what I heard, they are going to give these people a good compensation package. So I hope they have negotiated those terms, because if they've negotiated and consent and there's consent by those people, then the process is going to be a little bit, you know, smooth. But if those steps are not taken, and if the terms, if the grounds, you know, for laying off these people, which for redundancy it should be, okay, technology has rendered you useless in the company, there's need to lower the cost, you know, that just, it's the things they were quoting, yes. So I must say they have really tried. And in as much as we know that yesterday, I think, there's a one, I think the senator for Laikipia County was talking about how they're going to summon the governor and question how these people were arrived at and everything. So that's actually my point. How they arrived at these people? Why is it that I think in
and
as
it's
much
a big number.
Yes, it's a big number. And for me, it's the low earning people. The people whose salary probably will be around 20,000 on I don't think a messenger will be earning so much from the government. And I don't think that number of people, and considering Laikipia County has around 3,000 and something employees. So 176 who are lowly paid, how much difference is it making? I think those are the statistics that we need to be shown, first of all. And also, okay, now let's go back to the wage. It has been, now your question, now the wage bill, and if the wages are, the funds that are being given are being used, you know, for wages more than the projects allocation of resources and projects. Yes, a staggering 58% is a lot of money for salaries only. And I think even nationally, a lot of money is used to pay people. I think what should be regulated, I think that step that was taken was not really the best step to be taken, in my opinion. I think, first of all, we need to look at how much is everyone earning. Can we, according to the budget we have, the resources we have, and the amount of money that we have been allocated, what does the governor, the deputy governor, the county executive directors and everything, let it be reasonable amounts that of course it should be a reasonable amount. If, when I say reasonable, you know what I mean. Huh?
Yes,
reasonable amounts should be paid to the workers, not dismissing people, not laying off people. For me, it is not the solution. Mm-hmm. And yes, more money needs to be taken to projects, county projects. You know, that's a good thing. Mm-hmm. But let it be done in the right way. Let it be not be done by affecting other people. But, you know, you sacrifice some group of people who don't have say, mm-hmm. so that you say, okay, we are doing projects, we are doing this, we are doing this. What about slashing your salaries? You're earning a lot of money. That money is on top there. Mm-hmm. Yes, so that's exactly my opinion today.
Thomas, what would you weigh in into this? Was it a good move to sacrifice those people who are earning lowly? And the money that they're asking for to the counties taken to the wages other than the projects? And maybe in the as you respond to that, should also the national government embrace this? We have parallel programs with people, our offices that perform almost the same job. Should they merge, or maybe we should have them cut their salaries?
Okay, thank you Hillary. I'd like to say something. We had someone by the name Immanuel Kantor. He talked about self-interest. Immanuel Kantor is the major proponent of the idealist theory that is in international relations. He talked about the consequential theory of ethical Lewism. With respect to this scholar, people tend to do something that has self-interest at the expense of the general, at the expense of the public interest. Mm-hmm. What am I trying to say? Hillary, I can say that we have a lot of resources. We have a lot of resources both at the county level and at the national level. What you need to do is what we call financial prudence. How can we manage these little resources that we have? Mm-hmm. Like, for instance, you find that people are accumulating wealth for their self-gain and their self-interest at the expense of the general public. For instance, for the case of Laikipia County, as I told you, I was trying to go through that report by the chairperson of the County Public Service Board. And I'll advise my friend Jerusha to go through that report. This report actually did not cut across the lowly paid individuals. This report cut across the board. It cut across the board. Because with respect to the chairperson, she was trying to see, maybe for instance, you find that there is someone who is maybe working in the office of the governor. Mm-hmm. And if you try to ask such a person the kind of roles and duties that such a person does, the person can't explain clearly. For instance, you can find that someone is a personal assistant to the office of the governor. What are your roles? Are they clearly stipulated? What are your academic qualifications to hold such a position? You find such individuals could not actually explain such. So she also said that there are those people who perform nearly the same roles. Mm? So is there a need of having like 10 people performing the same role in the same department? No. So some have to be laid off. So in my opinion, I can say that we need to have what we call financial prudence. Let's try to make use of the little resources that we have, mm-hmm. and the rest of the resources should go to the development process, to the development agenda. That is what I can say.
Now, just a quick follow-up, just to get it clear. The report was saying people were working there, and then the questions were raised on what you do and your qualifications. Then the biggest question would be, how did they find themselves there? Who employed them in the first place?
What I can say is that we have what we call political patronage. From the class of political science, political patronage is the process of giving job opportunities or giving certain favors mm-hmm. to those people who may be supported during the political process. Mm-hmm. So in most cases, Hillary, you find that some of these people mm-hmm. never went to school. Like when I was going through that report, Madam Mumbi was saying that up to 200 people had no academic qualification, had no academic papers. Mm-hmm. So how do you find yourself in an office without proper academic papers? That is political patronage. Mm-hmm. So in my opinion, I think other governors should embrace this. Mm-hmm. We have very many young Kenyans outside here who are employed, who are actually unemployed, hundreds of thousands of them. Mm-hmm. So why employ someone with no proper academic qualifications? Mm-hmm. So I think what played a major role is what we call political patronage. And that is what's actually killing our development agenda, is what's killing our economy in the country, because you find people with no qualifications, get offices, which is not good.
All right. Jerusha, you seem to want to respond to that.
Yeah, okay. So basically, I think he has told me to go and read the report. I have gone through the report, actually. And what you're saying is true. Mm-hmm. Yes, the report cut across.
Exactly.
Across board. It was done by the county public audit committee, right?
Okay.
And what I am trying to say is this, huh? There are 200, actually you've said it's 200 people, it's 242, mm-hmm. 242 is the exact amount mm-hmm. of the number of people who did not have academic credentials. Mm-hmm. And you find that, they, in fact, they said that around 100 and something were from the water department only, mm-hmm. and others, health workers, and you know, mm-hmm. out of those 242, it's 176 who have been laid out. Why is that number? For me, what I'm questioning is the integrity of the process.
Mm-hmm.
I am not, you know, I'm not supporting the idea that the wage bill should be high and, you know, people should be working when they do not have papers and that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
If you have noticed, I am questioning the integrity of the process.
How they arrived to
that number. What did they, why is it only this 176? And yet, mm-hmm. if you look at that, you'll find that, yes, it's 242. That cut across board. Why is it that, and even when the report was being released, you find that most affected people, and you will support me in that, the highest number of affected people
mm-hmm.
are messengers, switchboard operators, and that kind of, the kind of people who apparently they were saying that we have technology now, we can share files, we can share files electronically, we don't need messengers, we don't need this kind of people. But you find that they did not say anything like the people, some of the people who have been laid off, there is nothing like, you know, there are too many executive directors here, there are too many of this, you know, the high positions.
And the assistants.
Yes. In the number of people who are laid off, yes, the report touches on them, but the number of people, the 176, mm-hmm. you'll find that most of them are these people who really actually don't really don't carry so much of the wage bill in the county.
Mm. All right, we are running out of time. Actually, I have less than 4 minutes. As we talk about our governance, in reference with what happened in Laikipia, would we see other county governments, they are okay? Is there something that we expect from them? Should they take the same move? Or what should be regulated in terms of, even of law, getting to lay off some employees, and what should be done? And also, are they in a state to say, we are fine, we are spending okay, as we wind up?
Okay, as I said earlier, Hillary, the major problem that we have in our counties is financial imprudence.
Mm-hmm.
I'll give three examples. We have the county of Migori, we have the county of Kisumu, we have the county of Siaya. These are the counties that you find that the finance departments got touched by fire. How did those fires go to those places and not other departments?
Mm-hmm.
You find that it's because that they want to destroy maybe some facts and figures, maybe so that they cannot be questioned when they go to the Senate Committee of Public Accounts Committee.
Mm-hmm.
So when they are questioned about how they spend their finances, the ostensible reason they give is that maybe the receipts and also and all such stuff were pumped down. So what I'm trying to say is that the major problem that we have in our counties is financial imprudence. This is why counties should employ competent people, competent characters to lead various departments of the counties.
Mm-hmm.
And as I said, another challenge that we are facing is political patronage. Mm-hmm. Hillary, you find an unqualified person
mm-hmm.
Is employed. So these are crooks who don't actually who don't deliver.
Mm-hmm.
So in my own opinion, I think that the governors should take a broader step to ensure that those people who are employed are competent,
mm-hmm.
they are qualified, so that they can deliver and make use of the little resources mm-hmm. that they have.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I can say.
All right, Jerusha, what would you say?
For me, what I can say is that what the county governments should be doing mm-hmm. is looking at where exactly the wage bill goes up.
Mm-hmm.
So let there be fair administrative action. Article 47 of the Constitution of Kenya. Let the people who are going to be laid off, if any, be accorded the right to, you know, fair hearing. Let the right procedure be followed. Let us see integrity in the procedure that is followed in arriving at any decision. Yes, there could be, and there are actually, in almost every county, people who are working without papers, but who employed them? There is a contract. And in law, when you breach a contract, you will face the consequences. The Employment Act is clear. So if there is someone who is employed there, they might have been employed without papers. What was the contract saying? If the job position said you bring this paper and this, and that is what they had, they didn't have others. Yes, it was political patronage. They got in, you know, through other dubious means. But let the procedure be followed in laying these people off, in, even if it means getting, you know, going to disciplinary hearing or something of the sort, just following the right procedures and telling, asking you, how did you get here? The person who got that person there should also be called to task and explain, how did you hire this person? You see, it's not like waking up and just sending people off because they do not have papers. How did they get there? Who got them there? What did they present to the office? So was there fraud? If there was fraud, okay, let them be held accountable. Was there an officer who just sneaked them in? Let them be held accountable. Every person should be held accountable for their actions.
Critics would ask, maybe the house is being cleaned because there could be a probe coming soon because of corruption. So these people maybe would have tried to snitch out of what happened and how they found themselves there. Otherwise, many thanks for coming and sharing your opinion. Apparently, we are out of time, and I'm sure we would have talked more about this particular topic. They have been my guest, Thomas Omao, political analyst or scientist, and Jerusalem Michael, a lawyer. Now, coming up next is Wai Mashariki. I'm sure DJ Teska and Ken Relbis, they are very much ready for you. Thank you so much for keeping us company. I'll be seeing you again next week on Monday. Good night. My name is Dereva Hillary. Goodbye.